probably 10 times a week, I get a roll of media and I've never seen it before. It is not on the HP Media Locator. I don't know where it came from. I might know what it does. And someone's asking me, hey, will this work with a latex printer? And I have an approach to media and how I run it that I think by communicating will help many of you who get strange rolls all the time that are not on the HP Media Locator. You don't know whether it works, and you got to figure out, how do I run this? The first thing is to figure out if the roll that you have is similar to a material that's already on the Media Locator. You know, that's illustrated in the video I made about finding surrogates, you know, similar complements. You know, you have a cotton fabric. There's a cotton fabric on the locator. They're probably pretty similar. But a lot of times I have no idea whether the media I have on, I don't even know what to associate it with. For example, this is a product by Visual Magnetics. Visual Magnetics create a sign system. It's a magnetic-based sign system. This is the POLYeight. And Visual Magnetics has some very, very fascinating, really, really cool stuff. But I don't know if this POLYeight's gonna work. You know, it may not be on the Media Locator for my latex printer. It may be for some or maybe not for others. But I wanna use this as an illustration for sort of how I approach the problem. Ultraflex, for example, has a very similar product called Cynetics. And I know that that is on the Media Locator for some of the latex printers. But the way I approach it is, the first thing I wanna figure out is, how temperature sensitive is it? You know, I need to kind of have a read on, does this thing turn to bubble gum at, you know, 220 degrees? Because if it does, I'm going to have to lower the heat accordingly. I divide all media largely into two groups, frontlit and backlit. Backlit also includes most fabrics. It can also include translucents or clears where I'm putting a lot of ink down. Usually anything over 170% density, I put into a separate category and I start at about 16 pass. Now anything that's frontlit, this is a frontlit material. That is, it's going to be seen refractively. I'm not illuminating it with a light. It's not going to go in a window. It's not going into a light box. It's not a fabric, a soft textile. This material is frontlit front reading. I start all frontlit printing. Polypropylenes, banners, polyethylenes, PET frontlit films. In this case, this is some kind of film. It doesn't matter what category so much, whether it's adhesive vinyl or PVC banner or canvas. I'm going to run any frontlit material at 12 pass to start. 12 pass is where I evaluate the material. 12 pass for me is the slowest acceptable frontlit speed that also will allow me the most ink with the lowest temperature and give me the highest quality. So I call it my 12 pass high quality mode. I'm gonna put as much ink as the material will take and build the best looking print I possibly can front reading. So this Visual Magnetics POLYeight, I would load on at 12 pass and then get some kind of understanding, sometimes by going to the manufacturer site, how temperature sensitive it is. But a lot of times I just have to pull the trigger and choose the temperature. So let's say I choose 220 degrees, 12 pass, and I run the first color calibration chart. So I know the speed I'm running, that's predetermined. I always run 12 pass to begin. Then I choose a temperature that I think makes sense. And then I run that first chart. Now, when I see it coming out of the printer, if it's all turning to bubble gum, it's warping every place, I just stop it right there and I know I'm way too hot. Then I'm gonna adjust the heat. So let's say 220 on this, just the media goes bananas. Okay, that's not gonna work. Now I'm gonna do 12 pass 200, run the same chart. How does it look? Okay, now I'm well under the media's temperature threshold and then I can figure out how much ink I can put down. So you gotta kind of get the first real determination is temperature. I've already chosen speed because I'm going to choose a slower speed to see what the read on the media is first. Then I'm going to dial in the temperature. And then all that remains is how much ink can I put down? So let's say this media requires 200 degrees to be stable. 12 pass will allow me enough temperature to then say, get 100% ink density at 200 degrees. Everything looks great. That's my high saturation. Keep in mind, Latex is printing 1200 DPI through all modes. So resolution is not changing. But what's changing is how much ink you can put down. That's partly determined by how much heat can go on the media. So I do test all medias, paper, adhesive vinyl, banner, any oddball stuff, all gets run at 12 pass to start. Now, if at 12 pass, it's a knockout. Takes heat, looks great, everything's spectacular. 12 pass, 120% density, love it. Now I know that there's a very good probability that I can build a 10 pass mode, an 8 pass mode, a 6 pass mode, or possibly even a 4 pass mode. But I'm going to start someplace to get a read on a material because I don't know how it runs. I have no idea how this material performs. If you were to start at 8 pass, you might conclude this material is not compatible with Latex. Not true. It's not compatible with 8 pass, 235 degrees on Latex. Perfectly compatible with 12 pass, 200 degrees on Latex. And since we run so many different medias, I find that methodology to be very helpful. I'm going to want a high speed or a high quality mode anyway. So the first mode I try to lock down is what's my quality? And that's 12 pass. Then I consider, well, if it fails at 12 pass, I may have to go to 16. Certain magnetics, O2O magnetic, for example, that's going to perform best 16 pass because I have to slow it down to lower the temperature so I can still put enough ink to have a high quality print. That's my methodology for approaching all the new medias that I encounter. I start with 12 pass on the front lit. If it's a fabric or backlit, I start at 16 pass. And if it's even a front lit that's very temperature sensitive, I'll find out at 12 pass whether that needs to migrate to 16, which I prefer not to do because there's a speed drop. But 12 usually gives me my first read that usually provides me with the information I need to know. So my methodology, it's just a simple shorthand. I found it to be very effective.